man.
National Drug Authority officials say that 65% of Ugandans depend on herbal medicines before going to hospitals, and that's why they have decided to carry out sensitizations on the proper use of herbal medicine.
65% of Ugandans, they are dependent on traditional medicine. And if you don't regulate the traditional medicine area, that means that percentage will be left to use substandard, ineffective.
Fred Kabuye, the National Drug Authority Head of Communications, says most of the fake herbal medicines are sold in buses and taxis, thus warning operators not to allow hawkers who sell medicines on buses, or else they'll face arrests.
So when our enforcement team stops that bus, they will arrest the bus operator and the hawker. Because if this bus operator had stopped the hawker from entering the bus, the hawker wouldn't have broken the law.
The head of product and assessment in the National Drug Authority, Enoch Nturuma, also revealed some of the drugs that are being hawked.
We all know these drinks, the kombuchas, okay? The kombuchas. Some of them have herbal remedies, some of them are alcoholic, some of them are non-alcoholic. So right now the thing that is on much demand for hawkers is what? Is these kombuchas.
They have emphasized on the training of all people handling drugs, and the government, through the Directorate of Industrial Training, has also given a chance to herbalists to be trained.
Are they trained? The government of Uganda through DIT, that's the Director of Industrial Training, is providing particular training for herbalists.
Kabuye says that NDA has been engaging different stakeholders for the past 2 years, and they've been told how to handle herbal medicines as well as how to register their products.
Now Ugandans can understand that herbal medicine is equally important as conventional medicine. And most of them now, they know that herbal medicine is also regulated by National Drug Authority.
And also, what NDA is doing to encourage and motivate the herbalists is that we are doing engagements and sensitization. We teach them on different areas of interest.
National Drugs Authority's engagements are ongoing throughout the country, and their main focus is on herbal medicine that they say is being abused. This report was compiled by Muhumuza Godfrey for the news.